This is Business Analytics Using Forecasting, and I'm Galit Shmueli. In the next videos, we're going to look at how to use regression methods to build forecasting models. We're going to start by looking at trend models. What is the idea of using a linear regression model? The idea is to use the predictors of the model to capture trend, or maybe seasonality, and the error part of a linear regression will quantify the uncertainty in those forecasts. We can use linear regression for generating forecasting, as in time series forecasting. We can also use linear regression for time series analysis for a descriptive goal. But our focus in our videos will be about time series forecasting. It's very popular because linear regression models are interpretable, and therefore lots of people like to use them even when the goal is forecasting. The key concepts that we'll see are a global trend and global seasonality. These will be different from what we saw in smoothing. Recall the different types of trend shapes for approximating a time series. In the next two videos, we'll see how to fit a linear trend, a multiplicative trend or an exponential trend, and a polynomial trend. The same concept of partitioning a series into multiple components, systematic components, and a non-systematic component will also apply to linear regression. We also talked about two different types of splitting. The first type is an additive decomposition, where we decompose the series into level, trend, seasonality, and noise so that when we add them up with addition signs, we get the series. The other type is multiplicative, where we use multiplication signs between these four components. The common patterns of time series that we use regression to capture are, for example, a linear trend, an exponential trend, and a quadratic trend. We're going to focus in this video on a linear trend. Later, we'll also look at seasonality. We're going to see how a regression can capture additive seasonality and multiplicative seasonality. Let's recall our earlier example of sales of soft drinks. We had quarterly data, and we're measuring millions of dollars every quarter from quarter one of 1986 to quarter one of 2001. We might have two different goals for the analysis. One is a forecasting goal, time series forecasting, where we're trying to create forecasts, say, for the next four quarters. A different type of goal would be time series analysis, where we're trying to simply quantify the components, and that would be a descriptive goal. Linear regression would be useful for both of these goals, but here we're going to concentrate on the first goal of forecasting. A linear trend model means that our trend is additive. In our quarterly sales scenario, this would mean that the sales grow by a fixed dollar amount each quarter. In other words, the trend is the dollar change in sales from quarter to quarter. To create a linear trend model, we start by creating a new column, T, which is a running index. Then we use this new column as the single predictor in our regression so that we have the model of sales, or Y sub T, equals to beta 0 plus beta 1 times t plus some epsilon. Fitting this model can be done with any software that has a linear regression function, but make sure you're only fitting the model to the training period. In Excel Miner, we would have to create a new column t, then we would partition the series into training and validation, and finally, in the predict menu, we'll find the multiple linear regression function. If you're using R, we can use the TSLM function. And there we specify trend as the single predictor. After you create the linear regression model, we can use it to forecast the future. And in this example, the second command generates forecasts for four quarters in the validation period. Here's the output from Excel Miner. From the output alone, we cannot tell whether this is a good model. For example, if you look at the p-values or the r-square value, you might think this model is pretty good. However, in terms of predictive power, the story is different. Let's look at the performance charts. We immediately see that the linear trend model does not capture seasonality. Look at the seasonal behavior that remains in the forecast error chart. Also, we see that the trend is not properly captured. Toward the end of the series, the trend model is overforecasting, especially for some seasons. What can we do? If we insist on using a trend model with linear regression, then we must account for or get rid of the seasonality beforehand. One option is to difference the series at lag 4. A different option is to aggregate the series to annual sales. This solution is useful if we need annual forecasts. Let's continue with this scenario for a moment. Aggregating the quarterly series to annual data is useful if we need annual forecasts. For example, our goal might be to generate annual forecasts for the next 2 years of soft drink sales. Suppose that we keep the last 2 years of our series, 1999 and 2000, as the validation period, and the earlier years will be our training period. For simplicity, we're ignoring the last quarter in the data. The annual time series plot no longer displays seasonality, and a linear trend model seems like a reasonable approximation. Now our linear trend model means that we assume that sales grow by a fixed dollar amount each year. Therefore, the running index now counts years. Here's the regression model that fits a linear trend to the annual sales data. Looking at the performance charts, we see that a linear trend is reasonable. The forecast errors indicate errors of the magnitude of about negative 1 or 2,000. Remember that this is in millions of US dollars, so whether this is acceptable or not depends on the application. We have now seen how to fit a linear trend model, but there could be other types of trends. So in the next videos, we'll look at a few other trend shapes.